what joy my painting, The Supremes, was sold on satchiart.com. So now I have the job of wrapping up this beauty and sending it off to Florida, to a happy buyer in Florida. So let's get started. I have all my supplies. I have my bubble wrap, archival tissue, packaging paper, as well as cardboard. So what I have to do first is fold the tissue, because that's the only thing that would actually touch the painting. So I'm going to fold pieces of tissue into triangles that would sit at each corner of the painting, and then also cover the face of the painting. So triangular pockets, that's what they advised. I'm going to put making these paper pockets, then I will put corners of the painting into the paper pockets, the paper pockets. After that, I am going to put some protection over the front of the painting and the back, so they make contact. Paper pockets. One more needle. One more. One more triangular paper pocket. In the corners and then back of the paint. Now I'm going to put some strong cardboard at the front to protect the front of the painting. That's going to be taped to the front, and then I'll put some at the back to prevent puncturing. So I'm going to cut it to the exact size, and it's 15 by 15. So let me just mark that. So, two-ply cardboard, front and back, to protect the front and back of my book. And the rest use for something, I'm going to use it for corner protection. So we'll look at that in a minute. Okay, so just continuing now. Almost finished cutting out the cardboard. So there we have it. One piece for the front. Just at the front of the painting. And the other piece will protect the back. And I'm going to take these two protecting bits to the tissue paper so they never touch. They never touch the actual painting. So let's put some tape. And it's 2-ply cardboard, or you could use foam board for the front and for the back of my painting. 2-ply cardboard protection. Front and back. So now we are almost sure that the painting would not get punctured if you're in shipment. Now we're going to wrap this in bubble wrap. The first layer of bubble wrap. When we do that bubble wrap, it'll show that we're getting great protection for our painting. So we have to pin bubble wrap and tape the bubble wrap securely so nothing moves. Nothing moves at all. Cardboard front and back, and now I'm going to tape bubble wrap over that. So as you can see, the painting is very secure inside there. So let's tape that down. Thank you. Patch and Wendy. The art collector gets their piece and they have to remove all these layers and look for the treasure that lies within. There's many layers before they find their prize. A lovely piece inside. Okay, so we have our painting, two layers of cardboard to protect front and back from puncturing. And then also we have our bubble wrap. Now, water damage could be a problem during transport. So we're also going to put a layer of plastic over this to prevent water damage. We have a roll of plastic and use two-ply, two layers. Or if you have really strong plastic, then you can use one layer or an extremely strong plastic bag. But anyway, the thing here is to be sure that we're keeping all possible water damage. Right, so we have our roll of plastic and we'll cut that and then wrap in plastic. So we have two layers of plastic. Okay, so now he finished wrapping in plastic sheeting, which protects in case there is water during shipping. Delivery, right? So we have to have plastic to protect the roof in case during shipping and delivery is a problem. So after putting on the plastic covering, we're going to put corner board. So I cut a piece of cardboard here. I'm going to fold it like this to create corner protection. Let's see. I'm going to have to cut it a little more. This as a guide, this piece, because we have several cuts to make. So one on this side to fold. And then another on this end to fold it to make the corner. DIY corner boards. It's pretty good. The corner protection. So let me do two more. Again, that's just securing the package during shipment. Let me do two more like those. And then we are ready for another layer of food board, or I'm going to use double cardboard. So I'm going to put two more pieces for corner protectors. Folding and folding for corner protection. This would be a piece of DIY corners, but you can also buy corner protectors if you're so inclined. I don't mind making mine. Attaching the corner protectors to the outside of the plastic. To protect during shipment. Make sure that nothing would hit the corners and damage our painting. So that's where we're putting in the corner protectors. So we have to just put them in place. DIY corner protectors. So one at each corner. Right, now before I put anything else over this, I have to make sure I attach the corner protectors to the plastic bag. Then I'm going to put a certificate of authenticity in the package, because we're supposed to leave that inside the package so that the collector knows it's an authentic and original painting. Certificate, and we leave it on the inside here. Actually, I'm going to put it under the plastic in case of water damage. I'll put it just under the plastic. So, name of the work, The Supremes. Artist, Jennylynd James. Toronto, Canada. And I did this work in 2020. And it's acrylic on canvas. Inches by 15 inches. It's an original. And then I sign and put today's date. Right. So this is my certificate of authenticity, and I'm going to put it under the plastic. So in case the water won't get damaged. Down. Let me just adjust this a little bit to get it under that plastic. Quick adjustment, and then I'll take back the plastic. There you go. So the certificate will be well protected under the plastic. Right, so there we have it. We have our protected painting in bubble wrap with corner protectors, DIY corner protectors. Now I'm going to put another layer of cardboard, that in bubble wrap, and then the final packaging. So I'm going to put the cardboard layer in front and behind. So now I'm going to put my wrapped plastic protective piece with corner protectors in another layer of cardboard. Find some edges here so it will fit. Because I have to make, I'm recycling a box. So I'm making a new shape box out of that so that it would fit my project. So this looks good. This seems to fit. I'm just kind of bending the edges a bit. We'll recycle this box into a different shape. Right. Now that I've tested it, I see that it works. I am going to do one more cardboard layer. Let's see if that's good. One more cardboard layer and bubble wrap, followed by the outer box. Yeah. to a cardboard layer. Piece on the side too. The box material that I have, I'm just cutting like half of this. So let's cut it. That I have all of these boxes that I bought over 10 years ago. I've come in handy over the years. If it's not protection, what is? I'm going to staple these cardboard pieces so that they stay together, and then we will bubble wrap. So I stapled the pieces of cardboard together, and now I will just tape them together. A layer of bubble wrap over this, and I'm going to wrap in the direction that is open. line, then you put it in the final cut. Then the buyer, this is going to be a tough job, getting off all this wrapping. But, you know, it's for the protection of the prize inside. Let me take this over. I should be sure as well to take the last half of the wrap. I'm going to get two different colors of bubble wrap. That's okay. It's going to look like art. Bubble wrap. Orange bubble wrap. Not many have this. For a lovely home in Florida. Right. So that is the last touch of bubble wrapping. And now we're going to put it in the outer pattern. Right. We have it in skin bubble wrap. Pattern. Now we will use our recycled pattern to see how it fits in that, as well as more cardboard. Yeah, so, here we go. Almost fit. We need some extra cardboard, and then we're done. I'm going to have to take off all previous bathrooms. We're recycling this ketchup. I'm going to get a bathroom here and labels. We'll just write over them. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Alright, please ship flat. Please ship flat. It's also right somewhere that it's fragile. But that's getting fragile. Now we have to use the edge of a box to seal up one side so I can now from one edge up here. So now I have the outer package fabricated, DIY package. I am going to what I call HTTP. Also putting in a copy of the label. They recommend taking over the label so in case there's water damage. This is a shipping label. In case there's water damage, it won't get damaged too. So that's what I'm going to do as I take. But I'm going to also take over making sure that I fix the shipping label in place. Over it with clear plastic tape. Going to take over the box. Just to be sure it stays. Near the edge here. Be sure this edge
and then glue. Ready to go out to a happy collector in Florida. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my website jennylynndjames.com/art and Art by Jennylynd James on Facebook. Subscribe to my channel. The box is ready to go out. I have copies of the invoices. It's neatly wrapped. And here we have some celebration in the back. A painting sold, yay! Celebration time!